Boy, was we not expecting this for our first episode of Pokemon Sun and Moon. The latest episode just came out for the brand new series. And definitely I wanted to do a first impression, see, hey, what is this like and all that, since there's been a lot of controversy involving the different changing of art style and animation, especially with the whole premise of this series as well, the fact that, like, Ash wants to go to school, and it was so weird, like, coming into the show, and especially, I think a lot more people cared about this more, the fact that we had the latest season that ended, like, the whole with XY, I heard, was, like, ending, like fantastically. It was like amazing animation, it was great fights, it was some great action development for Ash, and then it went all the way downhill kind of right about the end. But generally, let's know exactly if this is a good show or not, or whether or not you should be watching Pokemon Sun and Moon. Now, to stop a lot of confusion today, since I know that the Japanese names and the English names, I am going to be referring the characters through their English names, since that's what I'm used to, and a lot of people are used to as well. So we're going to be talking about them right now. Funny enough, like, the episode starts with Ash already at the Alolan region. Most of the time, you know, he just starts out, he's like, yeah, I'm ready to go. But funny enough, this was the first time that he actually did, and the good, like, proportion of the first, like, couple of minutes was just Ash going around, like, he was on, like, a Sharpedo, running around the ocean, seeing a bunch of, like, Pokemon. It's surprisingly enough, he even saw, like, when he was running around with, like, Pikachu, he saw a Litten, like, out there, which is one of the new, like, starters out of the region, and we saw pretty much every single one of them. I believe we saw, like, the water one as well, apart from the exception of Rowlet. And definitely, yes, immediately you get through the first few minutes of this show what exactly that it wants to be, as it's a lot more comedy based. It's a lot more like, oh, like Ash getting hit by, like, you know, this fire type moon, and he's like doing these dumb goofy faces alongside he's getting run over by Tauruses and everything. I was like, they're definitely going for a more of a younger audience, and I think, like, exactly with the games as well, like, the games is going for a lot more of the fresher outcome, since the fact that there's no gym battles in here. This is not, like, really, like, Ash's whole thing to, I want to be a Pokemon master, and the fact is, like, Ash, you're going to go to fucking school now. You're not only going to learn alongside with your Pokemon, you're going to learn some, like, you know, lessons as well, because, you know, it's always been weird that in, like, this whole, like, lifetime and all that we've ever seen the fact with, like, Pokemon. It's like, hey, guys, and all that, here you go, and all that, like, just put all your shit here. It's just like, you go send your children out to the wild, it's just enjoy yourselves, and just like, there you go. If they get killed by a Dragonite along the way, it's completely fine. But one of the other reasons that they're mainly here is that they actually won, like, a ticket over here. Like, Mr. Mime apparently won it, which was a little bit weird. It's like, that the Pokemon like him can get it. And the fact that they do actually have a request, like, to go in there is like, hey, deliver this egg to my cousin, Samson Oak. And I was like, okay. Which, like, we get to see with this Oak is that he's actually the professor, like, slash principal of this one. We do get to meet the other one as well from their games. I believe his name is Kukui, like, the new professor that we got. And honestly, like, the school thing, it looks, like, okay. It's like, I definitely say, if animation is the one thing I didn't like, where the characters' faces are, like, always derping and going, like, super off-model and everything, the one thing I'd at least say is that the art style is really nice. I like the art style, I like the music, it's very, like, nicely, like, fits the theme. It really is gorgeous when you look at this, like, world and all that. Is a very gorgeous looking, like, island place. It very looks like a tropical resort, and it's definitely somewhere that you would want to be. You would want to enjoy this. And then, funny enough, like, it didn't take too long until, like, Ash met, like, a bunch of the other trainers that he'll be seemingly be training with and going to school with. Alongside, we have, like, a very shy girl that doesn't seem to do too well with Pokemon. We have Lily, who is the girl in, like, the white dress, which I was kind of surprised, because it kind of reminded me of one of the Pokemon movies. I believe this is the Deoxys one, where one of the kids was, like, actually scared of Pokemon, and he didn't actually like them, and, like, kind of really reminds me a little bit about that. We have, like, also as well, one of the trial captains slash one of the island's masters. I believe his name was, like, Kiawi, like, the guy that had the giant fire dragon type monster. That was kind of cool. Like, I did like his Pokemon. We also as well had Lana as well, who was one of the first girls that we saw, who was the water one that had the Popnemo. And then, which everyone seems like to be, like, the new pairing that where everyone's going, is Mallow. Mallow seems actually kind of funny, I'm not gonna lie. She was, like, very interesting, and I know a lot of people are definitely gonna be upset, and I've seen people making petitions, like, bring back Serena immediately. Like, she had a kiss with Ash, they need to be together forever, and I'm like, oh my god, whoa, calm down. Like, people already, like, assuming that these two are gonna have a thing. It's like, like, it's only the first episodes, guys. And trust me, I think at the end of the day, Ash don't give a fuck about his own balls. He only cares about the Pokeballs. To catch them all, and he wants to be the very best. Like, that's all that that kid goes through his mind. And pretty much, like, one thing that shocked me in this episode was how quickly we met the enemy team in this. We get to see Team Skull, like, finally, like, first thing. And I'm gonna be saying, I haven't played the games as of yet. I still, like, the games aren't coming out till, like, I believe a week till today for, like, Sun and Moon. So I don't know too much information about the Pokemon and the games over here. But I will say one thing is, like, Team Skull, I kind of like that, like, at least on their animation, they're all doing, like, this hip-hop thing. And definitely when I've ever seen trailers of them, it's always kind of going for, like, kind of rap, hip-hop kind of music in the background. So I kind of did like that. And it's like, unfortunately, they were using a bunch of, like, shitty Pokemon. They were using, like, Zubats, like, the new versions of, like, Rattats were in there, and, like, some weird, like, poison fire snake things. I don't particularly know what they are, like, so forgive me on, like, not knowing some of these Pokemon already out of the gate. But yeah, that was weird. And then it's like this, like, oh no, this guy's like, yeah, he's like, I'm gonna finish this, and he's gonna use his almighty Z move, which, for people who don't know, in the game, Z moves are like this big special elemental thing that you have. You do like some dance or something in the game, and then you can use it once. It's your all-powerful move. It's a kind of, I feel like, a replacement to, like, you know, Mega Evolutions, because clearly in the games and all that, they haven't been saying, oh, we don't want to add any more. And then I think, like, they clearly wanted to back down from Mega Evolutions straight after a Mega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, and maybe they want to think that maybe this might be a little bit better. Use, like, one move, and that'll be it. So I'm curious to see how that is, since, like, at the end of the episode, Ash has already got one of these C-rings. It was given to him by, like, the island's guardian slash legendary. Like, I think it was, like, Tapu Koko, like, I believe his name was. It was a very weird name to pronounce, like, the cat thing, but I think it was, like, Tapu or Tepu Koko, like, the name of this thing. Which, according to it, is there is four guardians of the island, and that doesn't seem like it's counting the legendaries, which is Solgio and Lunanu. I forget what the bat one's called, but, like, so including on that, we've got quite a few legendaries to go through the show, and I think Jeremy that is gonna, like, he is gonna do these trial captain things, he is gonna do all of this stuff. But I think there was like, hey kiddies, look at the Z-ring thing, look at it, and they're like, you wanna buy it, right? I think it's just clearly there for, like, the little kids and all that to buy it. And it's like, hey, I can be like Ash. Other than that, like, I enjoyed the episode, but I was a little bit disappointed by the fact that, yeah, I don't really like the new change in, like, animation. I don't like it. It is fluent, that's the one thing I can say about it. It's a lot more fluent, but Ash is more younger than he ever was, like, which is annoying. He's always that little twat is gonna always forever stay youthful. That's the one thing that we've had to accept at this point. But I at least appreciated with, like, all the other generations that we normally got, like, especially going to Gen 1 to Gen 3, like, Ash was learning, he was getting smarter, and, like, you know, even with, like, Gen 4 slightly, he was there, and then Gen 5, he completely became a retard again. Same thing happened, like, Gen 6, he was a little bit better, and especially around the end and all that, but generally, I was like, oh, I really wanted a little bit more out of this, like, especially after we just had, like, what, 3 years worth of, like, the XY anime. So I generally am, like, looking forward to more playing the games. I've heard some raving reviews of it, but whether or not the anime, we'll have to wait and see. Mind you, the only first episode is translated. There was two episodes that did come out during this, so I might at least talk about the second episode when that's translated, but whether or not the fact is, like, hey, Panda, do, like, you know, reviews. I actually did do reviews of XY, and I actually enjoyed them. However, though, Pokemon has this serious problem, is the fact that it's one of those series that it's kind of a little bit, one, hard to review, since it's like, what, how much can you say apart from, here's the new Pokemon of the week, let's have a look at that and see how far Ash goes, because that is pretty fast, like, at the start of it, then it takes, like, a huge steaming hole when they're just like, no, let's just have fun, let's just look at some random, like, you know, oh, this is the Monster of the Week episode. Adding into the fact as well that people are trying, like, there's no other legal way to watch the sub version of it. They have already licensed, like, the dub version of this, so I am looking forward to that, but the fact is that it's a little bit annoying that it's like, there's no actual streaming service that you can watch the episodes of Sun and Moon at the moment in Japanese, which is a shame. So unfortunately, you have to wait on, like, fan translations, and that also, like, depends on quality, and that also as well depends on timing as well. So I don't know whether or not I would continue doing Sun and Moon. Like, if you guys, like, want to ask in the comment section down below if you want me to continue, then let me know. I'll be very greatly interested. I wouldn't mind talking about a little bit about Pokemans every now and then. But I will definitely say, probably like after this review, or I'd say mainly until the next week's episode, like episode 3, I'll probably have the game by then. I'll actually be able to give you an actual impressions of like Sun and Moon and how I feel about the game, because I've got some kind of high expectations for like all the reviews coming out of there. So I'm very much looking forward to the game. But other than that, the score I'd give to this episode, I think it was a fine episode. I think it was good. I don't like the change of art style. It makes Ash look more like a little brat, like it makes still kid. And definitely going for a lot more of a comedy-based thing. And I think from what the opening showed like that, I absolutely detest the opening. It's just so goddamn goofy. And it's just like, yeah, let's dance, let's enjoy everyone. I was like, oh, God. Like, it's just thinking about that. And generally, I think it's spoiled as well that Ash catches his first Pokemon in the Alola region. It seems like he's getting that little bug Pokemon in there. So that's definitely something he's getting. I don't know that whether that's going to be his first or he's going to get his Star-type first and all that. And seemingly, I think everyone's pointing that he's going to get Rowlet, so I'm looking forward to that if he gets Rowlet out of everyone, since like we've clearly seen as well that the water one's already been taken by that Chiclana. So I'm already looking forward to seeing if he's either going to get Litten, or is he going to get Rowlet, or if he's going to get both of them. We'll have to wait and see. That's all from me though, so thank you for watching as always. Definitely get at the end of this, I think it was a fine episode. Probably like a 6.5, I think it was fine and all that. I think definitely this is more meant for a younger audience, so definitely not meant for man children like myself, so definitely we're going to be leaving off there. Thank you as always for watching, and I'll see you guys though next time.